Hello everyone, my name is Shiva Khanya. I welcome you to the sentence improvement series. Today we are going to start with the 8th episode. But before we go ahead, I'd like to suggest you to watch the previous episodes so that you will get a detailed idea about this kind of question. Let's start with the first sentence. When sharks approach divers, they usually did so warily. The wrong phrase is, they usually did so warily. The options, as usual did so warily, usually did so wary, usually are doing so wary, usually do so warily, and no correction required. First, we need to understand the meaning of warily. It means carefully, so that the meaning of the sentence is clear to you. If you look at the sentence, it tells about the general behavior of the sharks. This sentence is in the simple present tense. Why simple present tense? There are three evidences. The first thing, approach, is the verb which is in the simple present tense. We use usually, always. These time indicators, they also indicate it's a simple present tense. And the third important thing, if you look at this sentence, it tells about the general behavior of the sharks. It is telling the general truth, a scientific fact, that when the sharks approach divers, how do they do? They do it carefully. So it is a truth. In all these situations, we always use the simple present tense. Coming to the wrong phrase, did is in the simple past tense. It should be do, because we are talking about a general truth wherein we use the simple present tense. D option, usually do so warily. The second sentence, once the event is over, many people claim credit for success and disowning the responsibility for failure. The wrong phrase is for success and disowning. The options of success and disowning, for success but disowning, for success but disown, for success while disowned, no correction required. Many people have done two things. One is claim credit, and second, disowning the responsibility. What's the meaning of disowning? Disowning means to reject, to refute. Okay. When many people claim is V1 form of the verb. In the same way, disowning should be disown. When two verbs are used in the simple present tense, they should be used in V1 form. ING form is not required here. This is one correction. Second correction, if you look at the sentence, we are talking about two opposite ideas. Many people, what are the opposite ideas? Many people claim credit for success, but they reject the responsibility for failure. Two contrasting ideas. We don't use and, we use the conjunction but. So, option C is the correct one. For success, but disown. Okay. So, many people claim credit for success, but reject or disown the responsibility for failure. Like in the example, you anticipate for profit, but you refute for loss. You anticipate V1, but refute V1. Two contrasting ideas are combined by but. So, this is how the correction is done here. The third sentence. In the early centuries of the second millennium BC, people speaking strange dialects akin to that of India moved in northern Iraq and Syria. The wrong phrase is akin to that of, and the options akin to those in, akin to those into, kin to those of, no correction required. First, we need to understand the meaning of dialects. Dialects means the local languages. Okay, and akin to means similar to. Similar to. What is the meaning? During the second millennium BC, people speaking strange local languages which were similar to that of India. No, the languages were not similar to India as a country. They were similar to those languages which were spoken in India. Try to understand the difference between India. The local languages were not similar to India as a country, but they were similar to the languages which were spoken in India. So, akin to those in India. Replace this phrase here and try to understand strange dialects which were akin to those in India, means which were similar to those spoken in India, moved in northern Iraq and Syria. So B is the correct option. Sentence number 4. Our foreign exchange reserves have increased substantial. The wrong phrase is have increased substantial, and the options are have been increased substantially, have increased substantially, have substantially increasing, have been substantial in increase, and no correction required. Very simple. Have increased is a verb and substantial is an adjective here. Always remember, we need an adverb to qualify the verb. Put an ly suffix to the adjective and you will get an adverb. So have increased substantially is the correction. So B is the correct option. Have increased substantially. Sentence number 5. If we had been one more good batsman in our team, we would have won the match. The wrong phrase is had been. The options had, would have been, would have had. No correction required. This is a third conditional clause. By the way, there is a complete lesson based on the third conditional. The link is given in the I button and in the description box. A detailed information with a lot many examples, the third conditional clause is explained there. Please watch that lesson. It will be beneficial for you. Back to the sentence. If we had been one more good batsman, it is basically speaking about having a good batsman on the team. It shows the possession. For showing any kind of possession, we don't need been. Had is enough. Like in the example, she had a car but now she has not. Means she had a car in the past. It shows the possession of hers on a car. She had a car and now she doesn't have it. Have, has, had are basically used to show the possession. So in the same way, had is the correction here, which is in option A. So option A is the right answer. Now it's your turn. The Honorable Court had taken a lenient view because the accused have not previous conviction. The wrong phrase is have not previous conviction, and the options are had no previous conviction, had not previously convicted, had not been previous convictions, had no previously convicted, and no correction required. You are going to write the answer of this question in the comment section. Before taking a leave, just a reminder, please watch the previous episodes in the same series. You will get an insight about how to solve this kind of question, that is sentence improvement kind of question. We'll be back very soon with one more new lesson. Till then, keep watching, keep learning, keep growing. Learn English with Shivakanya. Thank you for your love, time and support. Peace.